So I'm waiting for the slide to come up. I think there's some problem in the slide. Okay. Now, this is a case study about resource management. How do you actually, so let us take a PM allocated multiple tasks. Okay, multiple tasks from four different projects to an architect. He's a subject matter expert. So, but he's, I mean, his knowledge levels are very high. So, he's like a hotspot, technical hotspot. So, multiple tasks from different projects have been allocated to this subject matter experts, basically due to shortage of experts. And another one is unable to resist the delivery pressure or to please superiors. What happens is when you are having multiple different tasks of different projects given to a single person, it's very difficult to switch. It is very difficult for a technical person to switch tasks. So you have to make an operation and break an operation. You have to break and make. A lot of break make operations have to be done. This actually affects the productivity of a technical person. See, managers can do multiple tasks because they are not doing it. Their team members are doing it. So they can do multiple tasking, multitasking. But for a technical team member, it is extremely difficult to switch different tasks. So in this particular case, the paper tiger plan has failed because all four projects, the different tasks which has been allocated to this particular architect or subject matter expert, it actually resulted in big rework. Okay. So the key learning here is the multitasking and task switching is very unproductive, especially for technical people. So this is basically another kind of fat which is introduced by project management people only or project managers only. So this should be avoided. People think that, okay, he's a great guy, let me put him in 10 tasks. All 10 tasks will get screwed up. And some people, some architects which are smart, they will say that, look, I have more things on my plate, I cannot do this. But there are some very nice people, they will take all the things in their plate, but they cannot eat it. So they will spoil their stomach as well as they will spoil the food or they will waste the food. Okay, so what is the key learning? Say no to the stakeholders, but with the right reasons. How to say no? But you have to always add a no with the right reasons and resist pressure. The art of resisting pressure is very important. Maybe there is a pressure from your customer, there's a pressure from your senior managers, there's pressure all over. How do you handle pressure and how do you resist pressure is very important. And one more thing is frequently shuffling technical people from one task to another. Okay, you do this task now, next half an hour you do that task, then you go to that project and do this. It's very, very, it's a huge fat in a project. Okay. So multiple projects, multiple tasks for key team members is not really advised. Now, next one is about key team management related fact. Okay? How do you handle, this is all about how do you handle your team. The contributors of fact is poke on weaknesses and not encourage the strength of the team members. What happens is you poke the weakness. Many managers are interested in just poking the weaknesses of the team members. Hey, you are not good in this, you are not good in that, you are not good in this one. So when you start poking the weakness, that will induce a productivity loss or demotivation in the team members. Instead, work on the strength of the person. Say that you are really good in making documents or really good in observation. Why don't you do testing? He will get motivated to do that work. At the same time, he will do in flying colors. So the person and underplay the weakness. If you always poke on the weakness, the guy may not be able to give their 100%. Go behind small flies and leave the big fish. When you are having a huge project plan and if you have got a critical path in that, go behind the critical path which actually are very, very, I mean, weak tasks which can actually affect the overall project duration of the project. Don't go behind why the bus is not coming, why the team members are, don't go behind those kind of tasks which actually don't affect the timeline of the project. Go to some critical tasks which can actually affect the duration of the project. Don't follow up on low value activity. Low value added activities, don't follow up. High value added activities, recognize those and follow up those activities. Leave the low value added activities in autopilot mode. It will work by itself. Don't go behind the low value added activities. This is very important. Then PM's project tracking style. When you give a work to some person, he says that 5 days it takes to complete the work. Every day evening you go and ask what happened, you will get irritated. What you can do is at least, okay, if you want to really follow up on the 4th day evening, you can go and ask, are you going to complete tomorrow? So the micromanagement style may not be liked by multiple people. And also when you are actually tracking, you should know how to ask questions. Is he bluffing with you? Will you allow team members to bluff with you and get away with it? Or are you able to ask the right questions to the team members and find out the technical loopholes and then help him? Okay, so we should be able to challenge the team members to increase the performance bar. It's very important. The last one in the team management is politics between team members. One is seniors not sharing the information. People have hero cultures. There are certain heroes in the culture, like the cowboys. Okay, they will shoot. Okay, so this discourages the cowboy culture in the team. Don't create heroes in the team. Create like the Aam Aadmi Party now, right? Create the Aam team member culture. Everybody is equal kind of thing. So if you create that kind of a culture, it is easy for, don't create heroes within the team. It becomes difficult when you manage. But at the same time, at the time of performance appraisal, of course you have to give high performers higher hike. But when you handle or when you treat a team, don't show the difference. Don't show the difference while treating team members. But when you are giving some hike, you have to show the difference. High performers should be given more hike. Stars should be treated differently. But when you treat a team members, don't treat them differently. A star and a high performer and low performer, don't treat them differently. It's difficult. Okay. And also when seniors are not really sharing the information, then you have to set a KRA, key result area, that you have to create a successor for you, then only your promotion or your increment or your salary hike will be. So what happens is he will be forced to give information and create a successor for him. Otherwise he will hold all the information and becomes a problem for the organization. It's called technical hotspot. So it becomes a problem for the organization to have. Okay. So let me take some case studies of team management. So a manager pressurizes and reduces the estimated time by creating sense of urgency. So what happens is the overall project time, somehow you reduce the time. So team member, so when you put too much pressure, what happens is the team member will finish the whole work with reduced time. When you finish a work with a reduced time under pressure, what happens? The quality will be so less. So it is like telling, no, the coconut tree. Actually, the coconut tree, if you plant a coconut tree, it definitely takes two and a half years to get coconut. Suppose you plant the coconut tree and ask that after 1 year coconut is required, it will give only, it cannot give it. So you have to say that you have to wait certain tasks, you have to wait for certain time. You can't hurry up certain things. So actually hurry will spoil the curry. So hurry can get you into more worries. So don't hurry up on certain things which cannot be hurried. Okay, so another example scenario is team member whom you thought very highly contribute or very high hero has actually disappointed you. Sometimes what happens is you think that, okay, this guy is a great guy, let me just give the work to him and don't track him. Sometimes what happens is even high performers require some kind of tracking. If you leave a high performer in autopilot mode, some of them may work, give the deliverable, but some of them might require. So you have to do based on the context or based on the history. So basically it's a good idea to objectively